time now for First Alert Weather with meteorologist Rob Nucatola.
All right, let's just jump into the hot and the humid. We see a few spots this morning that are starting way up in the upper 70s. I think we're going to find temperatures by noontime into the 90s by 2 o'clock, probably into the mid 90s. And this afternoon, we're going to spend lots of hours, middle 90s and even upper 90s, all depending on if we can get some clouds, if we can get some showers. I say if because yesterday there were only a couple of spots that got a few showers in some of our southwestern areas. And I think it's going to be similar today where the shower chances are going to be really few and far between, and that means most of us with that long duration hot and humid. Not much happening, satellite radar composite style, not around here. You see some showers maybe up across parts of the middle of the country, but I think that's where a lot of that's going to stay. That next boundary is on the other side of a big bubble of high pressure. That'll be our big weather player for the next several days. 77 this morning in Tallahassee. It's 72 in Thomasville, and it's 71 in Valdosta. Not much of a breeze out there. The dew points are what we're watching, because if we can just remove a little humidity, maybe it doesn't feel as uncomfortable outside. And I still see some spots to the north and west, like up in Blakely, where it's just a little bit drier and maybe a little less uncomfortable. And it's 66 degrees. I see 71 for Camilla, 72 for Bainbridge, 70 for Quincy. And then as we head a little further south and east, Perry's at 74, Live Oaks at 73, so is Cross City. And it gets a little bit more humid the more south and east you go. The breeze today is still trying to come in from the northeast and east. That'll be the main wind direction, but it's not going to be breezy or anything. I don't see a lot of fog out there. I don't expect a lot of fog out there. Not really the deal we're dealing with today. Now, what we are dealing with will be that hazy sunshine. Plenty of it to get those temperatures going. And really, no outstanding feature that is going to help to bring any rain chances. Not when you have a big ridge of high pressure as our dominant weather player. And that's what's going to provide for more of the hot and the humid for the next couple of days, as this area of high pressure eventually starts to weaken a little bit and slide a little bit more to the south. But it is really going to be the thing over the next couple of days. And when you have this big ridge of high pressure, it makes it really hard for the showers to get going in the first place. And it makes it almost impossible for them to sustain themselves. So if the sea breeze or a little outflow boundary can start one or two up, they're likely not going to last all that long. You see on Futurecast, as we get from yesterday to today to tomorrow, there's not a whole lot going on out there. So I don't expect very many showers. I do expect lots of hot. Just be ready for it. And remember, in the afternoons, especially if you're outdoors, there's been those peak heating hours from like noon to five. Make sure you are taking those precautions, drinking plenty of cold water. I like to take that towel out of the cooler full of ice and wrap it around my head when I'm playing golf in this kind of heat, because you need to. Otherwise, your body will start telling you that it's getting too hot. I'm watching in the tropics a couple different areas, that moisture that moved off the Florida coast and this other energy that's trying to develop over the Bay of Campeche, both still with some life to them, neither doing anything quickly. And over the next week or so, we'll continue to watch and see if anything becomes of it. I doubt anything's going to become of that energy up the East Coast. And it's interesting to see what's happening with this. I think that might be a Mexico issue, but we'll certainly keep our eyes on it and see if anything does develop. On the Gulf, close to home today, northeast winds at first, west winds later, 5 to 15, seas 1 to 3 feet. Not bad for the boaters at all, just hazy sunshine and hot. It's going to be muggy this morning, 70s become 90s real fast. And I think we're going to see daytime highs into the upper 90s. I'm going to leave the rain chances like 20, 30%, that's it. Most of us not going to see a single drop for the next few days. We're just going to have those long periods of really hot. And I think overnight it stays muggy. We'll go with mid 70s for overnight lows. There's that forecast, and man, so hot. Hey, did you know the all-time Tallahassee record high temperature is 105, and it was set on June 15th, 2011? Well, tomorrow's June 15th, and we're expecting a really hot day. Hopefully not that hot.